Hey guys, I'm Tommy McLean. I'm the fire chief at Putnam County Fire Department in Eatonton, Georgia. And we're up here doing a final inspection on our new ladder truck. This is a Enforcer chassis with a 100-foot mid-mount tower on it. And we chose this chassis because of its, I guess, features, its agility, how quickly it can be set up, and the minimal amount of space required to operate the ladder positioning. We'll start by going through the cab. Enforcer cab, one-piece windshield. It has the American flag graphic in the grill. Federal Q siren is recessed in the front bumper. We chose the Enforcer cab so it would we could mimic our engines. We also have two Sabre fire engines from Pierce, and we wanted the cabs to be very similar on the inside. We have wireless intercom inside the cab that's connected to our radio. We use Firecom headsets for that. We have the TAC4 suspension to make the apparatus more easy to drive on the roads in our territory. We have in the back, our medical cabinet is in the center where we'll keep our medical equipment. And we have two air pack seats in the rear. Our territory has two large recreational lakes that border our county. So we keep some water rescue equipment in that cabinet as well. We got the Speedlays for our crosslays on the truck. The truck's equipped with a 2,000 gallon a minute Waterous pump. We upgraded to the heavy duty access ladders to get to the tower, so we don't have to worry about overloading those. Guys can get up and down safely. The outriggers, we didn't point them out on the front, but they come with the ground pads attached. So that's one less step that the operator has to do when setting the aerial up. We chose to go with pan doors on all of our compartments to maximize the amount of space that we have for equipment on these trucks. Now the DEF fluid goes in here. It's on the back outside the cab. That's a feature that we liked about Pierce. So in this large side compartment, we had tool boards added inside to maximize the opportunity to mount our equipment in there. Had pegboard put on the back wall. So we should have three solid mounting surfaces inside this large compartment. Our engines are red over red with black graphics. On the ladder, we chose to make the ladder black to accent that. The graphics package on the ladder matches our current engines. This truck's equipped with a remote operator for the aerial device and for the master stream device, so that you can stand away from the vehicle and operate the boom or the waterway and see what you're doing a little better than being confined to the turntable down here or even above the fire, potentially in smoke in the basket. We added saw boxes to both sides of the ladder just behind the bucket, and also a mount for the Stokes basket is on the base section. Inside of the top section is a roof ladder with double hooks on each end that we can use to access a roof once we get the ladder up there, or it can be used to get over a parapet wall with an attachment that goes onto the bucket. We always put this graphic, or we have been putting this graphic on our new apparatus. All of our apparatus in the past few years have been purchased with SPLOST funding, which is a penny sales tax that's voted on by the citizens of Putnam County, so that a large purchase like this isn't just funded off property tax, but by everything that anyone buys within the county. The waterway on the ladder itself is capable of flowing 2,000 gallons a minute. And each one of the two nozzles on the bucket can flow 1,500 gallons a minute. The fog nozzle is remotely operated with that remote control device that we looked at earlier. In the roll-up compartment, we have our cache of ground ladders, roof ladders, extension ladders. So the supply line is loaded in here and goes under the ladder in the bed of the truck. And this truck's capable of holding 800 feet of 5-inch LDH supply line. There's another heavy-duty access ladder on this side to access the bucket. We added a flag graphic to the side of our bucket. We thought it looked good and we like what it means. Got another large compartment here with two shelves in it. It's where we'll keep our high-rise packs. There's no compartment here because the water tank's behind this panel. This truck holds 300 gallons of water in a poly tank. Air bottle storage. And this compartment has another slide-out tray in it to help us maximize the space inside of it. One thing I failed to mention on the other side that we really liked about this truck is it has a camera above the side outriggers that projects down on the ground where your outrigger will land when you set the truck up. That keeps the driver from having to guess or potentially reposition the truck after he stopped. The intakes for the pump and the large diameter discharger on this side of the apparatus. On the officer side, we tried to move most or all of our controls to the officer so that the driver can focus on driving. The controls for the firecom intercom system and the sirens and the air horns are all located on this side for the officer to operate while responding. And the officer's seat is an air pack seat also. We added that steel mounting plate on top of the doghouse to make it easy to mount our equipment that's in the cab and chargers, like our Knox key secure systems. Behind the officer's seat, we added a 10 circuit fuse panel so we can add up all, we can wire up all of those extra things without having to get into the cab wiring of the truck. We upgraded the lights on the front of the truck so that we got emergency warning light in all of these positions and two headlights there. And we put a steel bumper on the truck. We had the top of the bumper rhino line to protect that edge, and we brought the NFPA reflective chevrons from the back to the front also. We upgraded the scene lights on the truck because we operate in a rural environment and there's not a lot of street lights in our territory, so we want to be able to light up the scenes while we were working. So we added a large light bar on the front. We increased the size of the lights on the side of the cab and added an extra light on the side of the body itself for scene lighting. We backlit the grab handles on the cab to help the guys not miss when they're getting in at night, give them a little something extra, and the red looks pretty good. We upgraded the lighting on the bottom of the aerial bucket so that we'll have better sight when we're flying the ladder, but these lights don't come on until the ladder itself is raised out of the bed. So if you're ever in Georgia in Putnam County, come on down to Lake Country and we'll be glad to show you our Pierce 100-foot mid-mount tower.